Alright, it's Full Like Meal with Riky Rick, nominated for Video of the Year. Dude, that video had a lot of controversy when it came out. What does it feel for it now to be nominated?
I think everything has controversy when it's really, really good, you know what I mean? So it was just a blessing, man. It's just a blessing to be nominated for my work at any situation. So I'm just happy, yeah.
Tell us, what went into making that video?
Say what?
What went into making that video?
A lot of effort and a lot of passion. My friend Adrian Lowe from Cape Town came together with me just to try to do something special on a minimal budget. And it was like one of the first videos I ever did by myself, fully by myself, out of my own pocket. So it just took a lot of passion, a lot of dedication, and the guys came through.
How does it feel like to be nominated and be back home in Durban?
To be nominated and?
Nominated and you're in Durban at the time.
Yeah, it's good, man. It's the first time I'm coming to an award show in Durban. So it's just, it's brilliant, man. I hope, I don't hope anything. I'm just glad to be here and just to represent my family, because it's my hometown at the end of the day also.
Tell us about the swag. What you wearing right now, bro?
Oh, no, it's too upper. Right now, I come through with a Puma bulletproof vest. And then I come through with the Rich Mnisi old jumpsuit. And then, of course, I hit it with the filling pieces at the bottom. I'm just waiting for the memes. I'm waiting for the memes on Monday to come out.
Top of the swag.
Yeah. Yo, this is your boy Riky Rick, and you are now listening to the African Hip Hop Blog the whole time. Let's do it. To life, to life.
It's your boy Fella, I'm here with Lynxxx. How you doing, sir?
Good, bro. What's going on?
So you performing tonight?
No, I'm actually presenting the first award. So yeah, it's pretty interesting. I mean, I saw the stage during rehearsals and it looks amazing. So I can't wait to see the show. You know what I mean?
So when can we expect your love music to drop, bro?
Man, hopefully before the end of the year. Been working hard and it is almost done, so it's coming out.
Who are you working with on the project?
Man, so many people. You know, Tiwa Savage, Banky W, Wizkid. I have an international collaboration on the album that I don't want to put out yet, but you know what I'm saying? It's going to be a very interesting album, so y'all stay tuned, man. Jollof music coming soon, you already know.
All right, dope. Look out for it, man. All the best. Thanks a lot.
I appreciate it.
L.E.S, how you doing, boss?
I'm good, yourself, buddy.
You've had a good year, man. A lot of brand money coming in. Ciroc, Sprayground, Deezer, now Vodacom. What are you doing behind the scenes to ensure that brands look to you as someone they want to represent?
Well, firstly, I just stay true to myself, you know. I like to stay fresh to death, keep everything really fresh to death. So as far as, you know, me, I like to stay true to myself. And of course, the music, man, the music speaks for itself. You know, I make really good music. I put a lot of work in what I do. And, I'm just very grateful that some of the brands have just reached out and been like, yo, L.E.S, you're the North God, baby. We love you.
Music-wise, you just dropped Paid. That's the first single of the new album.
Yeah.
Do you have a title for the album yet?
Yes, the album's called North God, of course. It was a nickname. Everybody just called me that. So, you know, I decided to just kind of represent the North and tell my story. I just think for my fans, it's just really good for them to just kind of give them the music that they love so much.
Yesterday you were joking about how you've been nominated so many times, but you haven't really got the accolades you might feel you deserve. How does it feel knowing that you've done so well, but you're not getting the recognition?
For me, what matters the most is just God giving me the opportunity to be here, to be recognized, to be amongst my peers. Whether I walk away with an actual trophy or not, it doesn't really matter. The one thing that drives me is my passion for work, for my work, for my craft, and just building my business and making sure that my family is fed, that my bills are paid. That's all I need, because I come from nothing, bro. And for me to be able to do what I do today and be getting paid and making a living off of it is a total blessing.
As a lyricist, you've really improved over the last 2 years, man. What goes into your writing process these days?
It's just me following what is going on in the industry and just keeping tabs with the latest trends and, you know, what the other guys are doing, you know. The only way that we can shining through and the greatness shining through is by seeing other people doing great things. I mean, you've seen in the past few years, the Coolie Chinas, the AKAs, you know, how they actually elevated the game. So I need to, whatever I had to do, I needed to come in on the same level or even stronger. So that's my motivation, just following what other guys are doing, putting in work.
Any plans for follow-up to Canada Republic?
Yeah, my sophomore album should be dropping in 2016, so I'm looking forward to that.
Thanks a lot, boss. Appreciate it.
This is best collaboration. You know what that means? When our brothers from Nigeria and from South Africa, we connect and we unite our people through music. So make some noise for Africa one time.